These are kitchen robots. These robots help with many tasks at home. But these are the real robots. They all work according to the program loaded into them. These are now used in most advanced factories. The smallest building block of a human being is the cell. Millions of these robots are working in our cells. Their names are proteins. Our lives depend on them. So, what are these millions of robots in our bodies like? Where is it manufactured? Who manufactures it? The robot machines that work for us in our cells are called proteins. The ribosome is the factory that produces all these proteins. In other words, a robot that produces robots. Something like that. In order for us to survive, 20,000 different proteins, that is 20,000 different robots, need to work in our bodies. The manufacturing site of all these robotic machines is ribosomes. This is a 3D printer that can do three-dimensional printing, plastic printing. It manufactures the shape I created on the computer by melting plastic. Simple things like this. The ribosome is a three-dimensional printer hundreds of times superior to this. It produces tiny robots with specific tasks. Dr. Derek Muller from Veritasium says the following about protein robots.
Personally, I'm astounded by these tiny molecular machines, how they're able to routinely and faithfully execute their functions billions of times over inside your body at this exact instant. I'm also...
In order for a person to survive, 20,000 different proteins must be produced and functioning in their body. In order to produce something in the ribosome, a formula for what is to be produced is required. 20,000 different proteins means 20,000 different formulas. The formulas for the proteins to be produced are in the DNA, in the nucleus of the cell. The nucleus of the cell is like such a computer. It has DNA in it. It's like the information processing center of the cell. How much information is in DNA? Here you see an encyclopedia of 30 volumes. There is 10 times as much information in the nucleus of a cell as there are in these encyclopedia volumes. And in this computer center of the cell, the nucleus, there are formulas for 20,000 different proteins. Let's go through an example. We eat, the food completely dissolves and mixes with the blood. It is carried to the cells via the blood. When food is digested, the sugar in our blood vessels suddenly rises above normal. There is a special receptor in our pancreatic cells, GLUT2. This receptor takes in sugar and measures it. When it sees that it has increased excessively, it rings the alarm bells. The brain of the cell immediately gives the orders to produce insulin. When the order to manufacture insulin is given in the cell nucleus, a scanner immediately finds the insulin-related information in the DNA. This is the product to be manufactured. This is the formula. We consider this 3D printer as a ribosome. This protein will be manufactured in the ribosome. An automated scanner quickly scans the insulin formula within the DNA. Then it outputs the formula as I chose. This needs to be copied. Another robot called helicase that unlocks the code in DNA. Then comes another protein called RNA polymerase. These operations are done entirely by robot machines. RNA polymerase converts genes in DNA format into RNA format. Well, when I extract this formula from DNA, will its place be empty? No. The nucleotides that will fill that gap are immediately collected from the cytoplasm. The copy of insulin is called mRNA, or messenger RNA. This formula needs to go from the cell nucleus to the ribosome. But the inside of the cell is not such a plane. Its formula needs to be carried by navigation in a three-dimensional space. There are three types of cargo vehicles inside the cell: kinesin, dynein, and myosin. Ribosomes also produce cargo vehicles. These robots with a specific task are no different from a bee that makes honey, or a chicken that lays eggs. these cargo vehicles use the paths inside the cell. The main roads and streets are called microtubules, 25 nanometers in diameter. The side streets are called actin filaments. These are narrow, 7 nanometers in diameter. A robot called kinesin carries the insulin mRNA. The magic formula came to the ribosome. So, what will be used in this construction? A separate robot is required to collect and bring amino acids from the cell to be used in construction. The name of that robot is transfer RNA, something like this. Insulin is built with 51 amino acids. This 3D printer does not use a single raw material, that white filament. There is also a protein produced by the ribosome from 34,000 amino acids, a muscle protein called titin. They are all micro robots. Insulin is produced in this way and secreted from the cell into the bloodstream. Its function is to reduce blood pressure to normal levels. Insulin will organize this. It stimulates receptors in cells to make them take up excess glucose. The problem is solved. The blood returns to normal. If glucose is still high, it is backed up and stored in the liver. Insulin resistance is the inability of cells to open the door to insulin. Let's look at it this way. We are eating the food. Normally, our pancreas secretes insulin. Insulin arrives at the cell gate. The door is closed. The cells say, "We don't want sugar." What happens next? Our blood sugar rises immediately. What does insulin do? It stood there with the candy in his hand. The last resort is to convert it into fat and store it. Is the problem solved? No. When the cells did not receive sugar, we were left hungry. Then this happens. Heading back to the kitchen, tired and hungry. What else happens when excess sugar remains in the blood? It leads to vascular occlusion, high blood pressure, and heart diseases. Eyes begin to see blurry. So, can scientists produce the insulin produced by the cells in our pancreas in laboratories? No. Scientists cannot exactly imitate this production achieved by pancreatic cells. So, how is insulin produced for diabetics? Insulin production is achieved through genetic engineering. The insulin gene found in humans is transferred to certain microorganisms in advanced laboratory environments. These microorganisms begin to produce insulin in their own cells. In particular, microorganisms such as Escherichia coli and Saccharomyces cerevisiae are used. These microorganisms are multiplied in bioreactors, and insulin is produced. In this way, insulin becomes available for diabetic patients. The body of that car is scratched. If it cannot be repaired, it will rot after a while. There is no car that repairs its own bodywork, but a miracle happens in humans. Look how. Let's say I got a cut on my arm. Instructions immediately go to the ribosome factories in the liver to produce the proteins fibrinogen and prothrombin. The events in insulin production are repeated exactly. The fibrinogen formula is taken from the nucleus of my liver cells. The same operations are repeated. A cargo vehicle called kinesin picks up this formula and delivers it to the ribosome. This time, the ribosomes in the liver do not produce insulin, but a blood-clotting robot, and the proteins that will allow our blood to clot begin to be produced. If robotic machines that clot blood in the ribosome were not produced, our bleeding would not stop every time we cut our hands, and we would experience blood loss. Biophysics professor Ken Dill describes proteins as follows.
And the case I want to make for you is that proteins are machines. You have 20,000 odd different types of machines in your body, and then other kinds of living organisms have other kinds of protein machines. There's tens of thousands to hundreds of thousands of different machines. And the first case I want to make for you is that these are real machines. That's not a metaphor. They use energy, they spin around, they pump, they act to cause force and motion.
Our robot machines are constantly being renewed. Those whose duties are completed are transferred to the transformation. We are alive thanks to these millions of machines. These robots are produced with 21st century technology. There are around 20 electric motors for movement at different angles. An engineering feat. This is the technological level that humanity's power and strength has reached. Now, let us try to imagine the power of God. Could the company that produced this robot make a 1 centimeter version? Very difficult. So, can they make a 1 millimeter model of this robot? Not possible. So, can they fit 10,000 of these robots into 1 millimeter? That is not possible either. But all these are nothing compared to the power of God. Millions of times smaller versions of these robots work for us in our cells. Each of them has its own special program. It all works like clockwork. And thousands of them are reproduced in every cell every day, insulin when needed, blood clotting protein when needed.